Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. I will bless the Lord at all times. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. This is the day which the Lord has made. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thought of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all people, meekly kneeling upon our knees. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbors in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through deliberate fault. We have not sufficiently walked according to the mind of Christ. We have named the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. We continue in prayers. Almighty God, you have taught us through your Son that love is the fulfilling of the law. Grant that we may love you with our whole heart and our neighbors as ourselves, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Please sit back for the ministry of the word.
The epistle is written in the epistle of first epistle of Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 5, beginning to read at verse 12. Now we ask you, brothers, to respect those who work hard among you, who are over you in the Lord, and who admonish you. Hold them in the highest regard in love because of their work. Live in peace with each other, and we urge you, brothers, warn those who are idle, encourage the timid, help the weak, be patient with everyone. Make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, but always try to be kind to each other and to everyone else. Be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Do not put out the Spirit's fire. Do not treat prophecies with contempt. Test everything. Hold on to the good. Avoid every kind of evil. May God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you true and true. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and He will do it. This is the word of the Lord.
The continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 14.
Glory be to Christ, our Savior.
Now the Passover and the festival of unleavened bread were only 2 days away, and the chief priests and the teachers of the law were scheming to arrest Jesus secretly and kill him. But not during the festival, they said, or the people may riot. While he was in Bethany, reclining at the table in the home of Simon the leper, a woman came with an alabaster jar of very expensive perfume made of pure nard. She broke the jar and poured the perfume on his head. Some of those present were saying indignantly to one another, "Why this waste of perfume? It could have been sold for more than a year's wages and the money given to the poor." And they rebuked her harshly. "Leave her alone," said Jesus. "Why are you bothering her? She has done a beautiful thing to me. The poor you will always have with you, and you can help them anytime you want, but you will not always have me." She did what she could. She poured perfume on my body beforehand to prepare for my burial. Truly I tell you, wherever the gospel is preached throughout the world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her. This is the gospel of Christ.
I speak in the name of God, the Father, God, the Son, and God, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please sit. In Christ's name, I welcome all of us to this service. It is another privilege to be connected with our Creator and to receive from Him. I pray that today what He has prepared for each and every one of us will be delivered unto us in Jesus' name. We are going to continue with our series on how to showcase our victory as believers. And we are going to look at attitude of gratitude as a way of living victoriously. Attitude of gratitude as a way of living victoriously. To serve as a springboard for this message, I want to present to us two alternatives that we face in life. As we journey through life, it is possible for us to look at our situation and complain, particularly for what we don't have. We can wallow in self-pity. We can also feel victimized and blame others for our circumstances. That is one alternative. It is also possible for us to look at our situation in life and be grateful for our circumstances, whether it is pleasant or not. These two alternatives have outcomes.
When you look at your condition in life and you allow yourself to be enslaved by self-pity, there are outcomes. Similarly, when you are grateful for your situation in life, there are specific outcomes. If we focus on what we lack and become ungrateful, I want to give us some of the outcomes. It's possible for us to feel inferior. You look at yourself. I don't fit in. It's possible for us to feel overwhelmed. Hey, this problem is too much. I can't cope. And that is why you see some people, they say they want to quit. And you see them committing suicide. Because they look at their situation in life and they can't see a way out. They allow their situation to bring depression. They become moody. Let me refer to those outcomes as signs of defeat. That is defeatist attitude. On the other hand, when we focus on benefits and goodness in our lives, and we are grateful for them, there is this satisfaction that comes to us. We are fulfilled. We love who we are. We like what we do. We like our condition. We are confident that the future is going to be great. We are happy. And because of the happiness in us, we relate well with people around us. There is this feeling of, I am in control. As a victor, that is what should be our attitude. You can't be victorious and still be depressed. You can't be victorious and be inferior. You cannot be victorious and be overwhelmed by situation of life. I've looked at our trajectory in this country lately. What has led us to where we are as a country? And one answer that has come to me is, you know, to the problem that we are having in this country. We are ungrateful people. So ungrateful to God. We cannot see myriads of blessings, myriads of His goodness that are surrounding us. And so we feel inferior to the extent that we want to undo one another. And that is why people in power, they are not doing anything to even harness what we are blessed with. And that is why the message this morning is of essence. Living victoriously with attitude of gratitude. And I want to pick my text from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Gratitude is a thankful appreciation of benefits that we receive on a daily basis, tangible and intangible. What we do when we express appreciation, we are recognizing the blessings of God in our lives, and that the source of this blessing is not in us, is not with us. And by extension, we appreciate our benefactor. It is the attitude of victors. As believers, the Lord has done so much for us. He rescued us from sin, from the world, and from death. And He has given us the hope of eternity. As a result of this, we must daily be grateful, even in the midst of the upheavals around us, because the situation in this country now making so many people to see no reason to be thankful. We must be thankful and be grateful to God. It is His will for us. The woman in Mark chapter 14, some scholars say Mary Magdalene, but Mark has not given us the name. It's just a woman coming to the realization of what the Lord has done for her, came to the Lord to express appreciation. She put up attitude of gratitude. She came with that oil, expensive perfume, and poured it on the feet of our Lord Jesus Christ in appreciation of what the Lord has done for her. She satisfied her emotion of gratitude to the admiration of our benefactor. Even when she was derided, our benefactor said, "What she has done, we forever be praised." This morning, dear people of God, I want to ask you, have you found reason to be grateful to God? Do you even express appreciation when you go to the Lord in prayer? What do you do? Is it not to ask, to ask, to ask? I want this. I need that car. I need this house. I'm looking for land in Banana Highland. It is London that I want to get an apartment. What do you do when you go to the Lord in prayer? Can you see His blessing in your life? Are you satisfied? Are you confident? Are you happy? Are you in control? As victors, attitude of gratitude is what can sustain a victory. One scholar said, gratitude is the greatest of all virtues. He said, but it is even more than that. It is the parent of all virtues. If you are not grateful, you cannot love. If you are not grateful, you cannot worship God. Instead of you being a worshiper, you will be a warrior when you are in the presence of your Creator. The message to us today is to inculcate the attitude of gratitude, and we must demonstrate our appreciation of God's blessings in practical terms, the way we live our lives. Apostle Paul in Colossians chapter 2 verse 7 says, our lives must be overflowing with gratitude. When you are grateful for your situation, it will affect your relationship with others. I want to give us a few ways of demonstrating our appreciation in practical terms. Number one, we express gratitude to God by walking upright before Him. Holiness is telling God that you are not taking Him for granted. The psalmist says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. And he started naming them, not talking about money. In his bank account, forgiveness of sin, healing, deliverance. And if you continue in that psalm, the psalmist says he will continue to live his life to appreciate the Lord. When you are unholy, you are taking God for granted. Another way to demonstrate our appreciation in practical terms is by giving generously and cheerfully to the cause of His kingdom. Giving generously and cheerfully to the cause of His kingdom and to others. If we are truly grateful, we will share what we have with God and our neighbors. There is this popular illustration, and we are talking about giving. A father coming home with popcorn, a bucket of popcorn, released it to his son. He said, what do you say? And the son will say, thank you. Okay, let me have some. In appreciation of what the father has done, the son is expected to release the popcorn to the father. But we have some naughty children that will now hide it. Are you the source of that popcorn in the first place? If you want to sustain your victory, if you want to continue to enjoy the Lord, be grateful for life. Be grateful for those little blessings in your life. And you now see the way God will continue to fight your battles. The Yorubas, they said, if a child knows how to express thankfulness, he will continue to receive. He will continue to receive. As I conclude, I want you to meditate on this very nice statement by Ralph Waldo Emerson. Cultivate the habit of being grateful for every good thing that comes to you, and to give thanks continuously. And because all things have contributed to your advancement, you should include all things in gratitude. I pray that God Almighty, who is our benefactor, will plant His Spirit inside of us to be grateful at all times, and you will remain victorious. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. In the name of God, the Father, God, the Son, and God, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men of our salvation. He came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please kneel for the intercession. This morning we pray for the Right Reverend Dan Ikemi Jaholia, Bishop of the Diocese of Ehahamuvu, and Mrs. Regina Holia, President, Mothers Union and Women's Guild, Diocese of Ehahamuvu, all clergy, children, and wards, the Bishop of the Diocese of Central Buganda in Uganda, the Right Reverend Michael Lubao. Also, in our prayer this morning, remember all the birthday celebrants for today: Mrs. Tolulope Obajimi, Mrs. Titi Lola Ilori, Master Detilewa Ojengbede, Master Toluwanimi Kuti, Mr. George Nihihadi, Mrs. Taiwo Abayomi Babaniji, Mrs. Kende Temitope Jemirigbe, Master Joshua Ajana, Miss Temiloluwa Olubi Adenekan, Miss Cindy Raphael Okechuku, Mr. Feintola Babajide Peters, Mr. Adetokunbo Ogunde, Mrs. Olufunke Daudu, Mr. Adeyemi Balogun, Miss Adepeju Adegunloye, Mr. Tekena Edmond Adewusi, Mr. Oluwafemi Sopo Amosu, Mrs. Lillian Victoria Enendu, Mrs. Josephine Ezireno Idele, Mrs. Ibiduni Lori Awoyemi, Mr. Emmanuel Kanu, Mr. Chikaelo Ivekadu Okoye, and Master Oluwatobi Oniwide. That the Lord will grant them many more years in the land of the living. Also, we remember those who celebrate their wedding anniversary, Mr. and Mrs. Olarewaju Feintola, and Mr. and Mrs. Gordon Ishapere. For our memorial intercession, we remember Mr. Francis Taiwo Gibson Robert, 41 years mind. Family intercession, we pray for the families of Dr. Olumide Osborne Phillips, Chief Dr. Oladele Fajemirokun, Mr. John Momo, late Dr. Ieno Sodende Akinrele, Mr. Fred Ore Olorun Ore Daudu, late J.H. Duarte, late Dr. Joseph Akani Duarte, late Pademola Thomas, Prince Biodun Famuagu, late Sir Joe Heonde, Mr. Emmanuel Kano, Mr. Lekan Leguda, and late Mrs. E. Modupe Ko. That the blessing of God will continually be the portion of these families. We also pray for the following businesses: Alizuta Limited, Medili Nigeria Limited, ELM Consulting Limited, Estelle Services Limited, DF Groups, Alpha Global Messengers, S&G Constables, Leonard Cargo Services Nigeria Limited, Quintus Projects Limited, Louis Alexander Ligo, Creative Shepreno, and Lagos Court of Arbitration and Rapturable. That God's blessings will be upon all these businesses. Lord, in your mercy, now let us individually present our personal petitions unto God. As you come with the heart of gratitude, attitude of gratitude to God, your maker, your benefactor this morning, tell him your heart desires, tell him your challenges. Our God is a great God. You have come to his house, to his sanctuary this morning. He said, come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Lord, in your mercy, let us pray for the church and for the world. And let us thank God for his goodness.
For the peace that is from above, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of God's holy church, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For our bishops and other ministers, especially Henry, our primate, Bamishebi, our bishop, and that with a good heart and a pure conscience, they may accomplish their ministry, let us pray to the Lord. For the rulers of our country and all in authority, let us pray to the Lord. For the poor, the hungry, orphans and widows, and those that suffer persecution, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For ourselves and all who confess the name of Christ, that we may show forth the excellency of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light, let us pray to the Lord. That with all his servants who have served him here and are now at rest, we may enter into fullness of his unending joy. Let us pray to the Lord. Almighty God, for the founder of all wisdom, you know our necessities before we ask and our ignorance in asking. We pray you to have compassion upon our infirmities and those things which for unworthiness we dare not, and for our blindness we cannot ask. Vouchsafe to give us for the worthiness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please stand. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Thanks be to God, who always leads us in triumphant in Christ, and through us spread everywhere the fragrance of the knowledge of Him. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which the earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become a spiritual drink. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right. It is our duty and joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, for he is your living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born as man and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, this gift of bread and wine may be to us his body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his suffering of himself made once for all upon the cross, and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. As we look for his coming in glory, we celebrate with this bread and this cup is one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him a great high priest this sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your spirit. Inspire us with your love and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you on earth and in heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting our own righteousness, but your manifold and great mercies, we are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table. But you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thanksgiving. Draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave you, and his blood, which is shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. God of constant mercy, who sent your Son to save us, remind us of your goodness. Increase your grace within us, that our thankfulness may grow through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, it declared your love. Give us grace and open the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Please sit. It's now time for family harvest. If we have any family wanting to come to the altar, kindly do so at this time. Family harvest. We have the following: Chief and Mrs. Golan, your daily CPA, Chief Dr. E. Olasende Akishete, CPA, Baba Shola Adebajo and family of Gibson Robert and Mrs. Dola Kokuka, CPA, Chief Felix Fagbongbe, SAN and family, Mr. and Mrs. K.O. Ume, family, Regu Martins, family of Dr. Michael Olushola Abiodun, family of Prince ICO Omogbeyin JP PMA, the family of late Reverend Canon Lawrence Nwaka, family of late Mr. and Mrs. F.O. Meadows, Mr. and Mrs. Fidelis Okonko, family of late Akinlolu Soyanwo, the family of Prince and Dr. Mrs. Adeyemika Ademiluyi, Mr. and Mrs. Steve Amiri, Mrs. V.N. Fumi and family, the Ajay Igbe and family, late Pa Solomon Adeshina of Williams, late Dr. J. Akoni Duarte family, Prince Famu Agu and family, Mr. Maduin Wizu and family, Professor Debo Adeyemi and family, Mrs. Olashubomi Fashola and family, Mr. Shegun Elliott and family, Mrs. P. Owowo and family, Mrs. G. U. Demba and family, Ogaje H. Doherty, Mr. Adeniyi Campbell and family, and Mrs. Modupe Oluwa Showemi Mokuka and family.
It is to serve the Lord. It is a great thing to serve the Lord, walking in the light of God. Oh, walking in the light. Oh, walking in the light. Oh, walking in the light. Walking in the light of God. Oh, it is to serve the Lord. It is a great thing to serve the Lord. It is a great thing to serve the Lord. Walking in the light of God.
Let us pray. As the earth remains, says the Lord of hosts, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease. Eternal Father, indeed we are grateful to you for the fulfillment of your word in our life again today. We thank you, Almighty God, for your family, the family that are present before this holy altar this morning, to thank you for your goodness and your faithfulness to them in times past. Father, accept their thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. We pray that the Almighty God will bless your thanksgiving offering in the name of Jesus. And by reason of this offering, you will spend your days in pleasure. You will spend your years in prosperity in the mighty name of Jesus. You will never experience a better yesterday in the name of Jesus. The Almighty God will continue to make your today to be better than your yesterday in the name of Jesus. God will meet you at the point of your knees in the name of Jesus. You will be fruitful in every areas of your life in the name of Jesus. As you are beginning another year today, we declare that this shall be your best ever in the name of Jesus. It shall come to be well with you. Thank you, everlasting King of glory. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Once again, in Christ's name, I welcome you to this service, and I pray that real joy will be your portion in the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to welcome to the cathedral today the Reverend Canon Abimbola Aduroja. He's the vicar St. John's at St. Andrew's Church, Marine Road, GRA Apapa. He's keeping residence in the cathedral today, and he has celebrated the Eucharist at this service. At the remaining services at 9:15 and 11:15, he will be preaching the word of God to us. I want to pray for him that God Almighty will continue to bless and prosper his ministry in the mighty name of Jesus. So you are welcome. Canon, it is well with you forever. I want to appreciate all of us for our contribution to the success of our Young People's Harvest last week. It was a success, and I pray that God, who is the giver of all, will replenish our pockets in the name of Jesus. Let us note item number 4, that is talking about our annual 3 Cathedral Choirs Festival, is holding next week at 4 p.m., at 4 p.m., not 5, at 4 p.m., and it will feature the choir of the Cathedral Church of Christ, Marina Lagos, the choir of Archbishop Viney Memorial Church, Cathedral Ikeja, and the choir of Cathedral of St. Jude's, Ibute Meta. It promises to be an exciting time in the presence of the Lord. We are going to be here singing praises unto his holy name, exhibiting our attitude of gratitude. And on the 26th of September, we are going to have a diocesan festival of hymns and anthems. Diocesan will be there. Choirs from across the diocese will also be there to render beautiful hymns and anthems to the Lord. You are cordially invited. I pray for you as you go into the world this week, the Lord will give you reason to be thankful unto him. You will not stray away from his presence. He will be your God. He will fight your battles. And all the days of your life, you will be victorious. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. May we please rise to bless ourselves in the words of the spiritual tonic for this week. The tonic is taken from Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. It reads, I can do all things through him who gives me strength. Now take your portion. My Father and my God, I thank you for blessing me with your power to do all things. Today, I go in your strength to demonstrate the power of your kingdom. In your strength, I will touch lives of others positively. They too will know your power and love. In your strength, I will soar above all challenges and achieve success. Because your power indwells me, diseases and disease-causing agents will melt and vanish in my presence. And in your strength, I will disgrace Satan and his court. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Son. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for approving my declaration made in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, my advocate and redeemer. Amen. As you have claimed it, so shall it be for you in the mighty name of Jesus. You will move from victory unto victory, from celebration unto celebration. In this week, you will not mourn in the name of Jesus. Thank you, eternal Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The Lord be with you. Let us kneel for the benediction.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.